sees his way right up the middle. Took a big hit. No penalty called. And the fans here are irate. Landeskog wants to go. Here we go. Landeskog is shit. Right by Landeskog. He's right in the right. His lid is off. A couple of runs by the captain. Oh, he's sprayed in right on Shin's head. Down goes Shin to the ice. Gabe Landeskog just went to town on Braden Shin.
I just turned towards the bench, and there was a pack of, 15 guys in a space of about 2 feet on the bench.
Peter, do they love and admire Gabe Landeskog?
Oh, my gosh. You talk about solidifying your role as a captain of the hockey club?
Here comes Landeskog into the Montreal end. Landeskog down deep, shoots, and scores! Welcome back to the lineup, captain!
Where guys go hard to the net, and right there, Gabe Landeskog, who... You know, the one thing you can absolutely guarantee yourself, that he is stronger today than he was when he got hurt. Those guys work so hard.
Comes into the zone, right side of Rene. Yossi just got hammered to the ice by Landeskog, and there's going to be a penalty called here as Shea Weber came back, captain on captain, to defend his defensive partner.
Weber wastes no time at all, singling Landeskog out for a heavy hit on Roman Yossi. And the captain unloading. Big right-handed bombs. Landeskog comes back with a couple.
Erik Karlsson's lost his helmet. Here's McCarr with a long shot. Loose in front. They score! Landeskog!
But a battle won in the wall. A keep in by Cale McCarr. And the quick wrister through the traffic. Bounces off a couple bodies. And Landeskog is there to put it home for the overtime winning goal. Puck to the net, funnel to the net, finish it off. A lot of goals have been scored that way in this series, just by getting to the net on shots from the blue line.
Down the wing, pass was broken up, and then cut down was Landeskog. He goes into Riddick, and now we've got a ton of pushing and shoving. Quick conversation with Ekholm back behind the net, and he's getting angry, and Ekholm's getting a piece of him. He's yanking on his lid and tore his helmet off. Did Ekholm, and threw it. And now here comes McCarr, and Kadri's involved. Mikko is red hot, and now we may have a fight. Landeskog's going to go toe-to-toe with Ekholm, a couple of rights. Landeskog leveling Ekholm, and he pounds him down to the ice.
Under no way was he meaning to dive into the goaltender. He just goes down. Well, Reddick, but Reddick's going to get upset. You can hit
him. Of course,
he is.
Absolutely.
Sure. Now Ekholm rips the helmet off right here. There was something going on earlier because of this. Now off comes the helmet.
Then he threw it.
And now here comes Gabe Landeskog, and Ekholm just wasn't ready for this.
Not at all.
Yeah. And Moj, you and I, you know, we've been around the Avalanche. Gabe Landeskog's a big man.
So Avalanche with a goal, and they follow up with the big boys, and here's Landeskog breaking in. Scores! A beauty for Gabe Landeskog.
This is phenomenal by Gabriel Landeskog. Through the neutral zone with speed, through Soucy and Brodin, and to the back of the net on the backhand. What a spectacular rush, headlong by Landeskog, the captain. They should have taken a penalty on him right there.
Well, Landeskog can win it. He can be the hero tonight, going wide. Landeskog for the win.
Alexander Kerfoot, Landeskog, and Rantanen in a fight off the faceoff. It is Shen and Landeskog.
What a way to start the contest.
And a couple of lefts by Shen. He rocks Landeskog. Now he gets one back on Shen. And this is a heck of a light heavyweight fight. There's Shen and Landeskog. 3 seconds in. And now some lefts by the Avalanche captain. Shen's jersey is over his head, and he fights back, and he lands a right.
Pass across and a skate, and O'Reilly steals it away. Gets to the fight from Landeskog. He cuts in. He shoots. He's good. this play. They break it up at the blue line. Looked like Pittsburgh was coming along. And just, I mean, you just don't see an NHL defenseman get beat like this very often. What a nice move by Gabe Landeskog.
Carried out. Tyson Berry, Nathan MacKinnon. Walking Spurgeon, a drop pass for Stastny. What a goal again! Tic-tac-toe! Gabriel Landeskog gets the pass from Paul Stastny. How about that?
MacKinnon's fifth assist of this early playoff series. The no-look backhand swivel pass from Stastny to Landeskog, and he's got his second goal of the period.
Tie.
We have him. Battle it. The red line. Landeskog going toe-to-toe with Kraus. Linesmen separate. Couple of rights by Landeskog. That one missed. Couple of rights by Kraus. Landeskog with a right there. Another right. Another right. Another right. Another right by Landeskog. Another right by Landeskog. Another right by Landeskog. And another right. And he keeps raining rights on Kraus's head.
Centering pass. Landeskog took it away for the Avalanche. Trying to get by Ovechkin. Boy, he went right by him. Shot.
Wow, what a play.
That's the danger of this kind of situation, is that a player is going to, you know, get the full head of steam going, and Ovechkin's going to try to have to play him like a defenseman. He just misses, and Landeskog is so strong. Bounces through him.
Pick away by MacKinnon. He gets knocked down by Truba. And MacKinnon shaking up on the play.
Yeah, he gets
and Landeskog is challenging Truba.
Yeah. Truba wasted no time.
Those are two strong men.
Truba nailed him all right. It's a clean hit. You see MacKinnon looking down for the puck. By the time he looks up, there's Truba. He just read it, drifted right into him. And again, everything is down. Look at his shoulder first. And that's just a clean body check. And Landeskog comes right over to him. Said fine.
MacKinnon and Johnson are the three out for the Avs. The pass in the middle, tip, and score. Landeskog tipped it, and the Avalanche win the game 22 seconds in to overtime.
Right, they scored some goals. They scored 10 goals now in two games. Overtime game winner for the Avalanche is the Avalanche facing the toughest first five games in their history.